on, Keenan.
Well, I'm on top of Empath, tier one, and they just started clearing snow. It's already melting a lot, so I'm psyched. It's gonna be an endeavor.
It was basically me and Paige and Pablo on the route the whole time, which has been pretty rad.
Each of us brings something different to the crew and to the process.
There's so many ways to approach a project, and there's so many different ways that would work. From the ground, you've kind of been doing either all squeezing or all like kind of lie-backy style. Just having to do that same style of climbing, I think, is why the end is quite hard.
When I first started climbing on it, I was like, this is like top five routes to me in the world. It was a project still. And I remember telling Jimmy that it would probably take me 5 years. When I first started climbing, I would always try things that were like five or more grades beyond my ability. But trying something that's one grade harder doesn't necessarily mean it needs to take you 5 years.
I don't have these past experiences where I'm like, okay, this works for me and this doesn't. Whereas Paige brings this massive, you know, like 2 decades worth of knowledge.
It feels good. Like, I feel like I've made pretty good progress from day one when I couldn't even cam.
We have such a different approach, and yet it like works for both of us in just a very different way.
As soon as I can do all the moves, I know the route's possible. That doesn't mean I'm gonna do it, but it's possible.
She's so chill about projecting, and I'm just like freaking out. That's like the goal. It's like, you know, Zen master style. She's just like, yeah, I'm just gonna try hard and then it's gonna be what it's gonna
be.
Come
on. Tension here, tension. Come on, Paige, try hard. Come on, Paige. Yeah, come on, Paige. Get that cam. That's it, come on. Come on, Paige. Come on. Keep going, keep going. Come on, Paige. Yoo-hoo-hoo. Dude, that was so sick, dude.
I mean, my mind was open. I was like, I could do it.
Bob and I had a moment staring when you were at the rest where we were like, oh my God, is he just gonna do it right now?
My goal is always to learn something about myself and my climbing, and that's what I did. I came here and tried as hard as I could, and I'm content with the outcome. Even without the send, I get to walk away and take those lessons with me.
Like trying to understand this sport.
Pablo is this young crusher. He's like this really low-key boulderer who has just been on a tear. He's super chill and brings really positive energy to the cliff.
Pobs and I would be talking in our Cali lingo or whatever, and Paige would just be like, what the fuck are you guys talking about? And just, nothing is Seahawk, like, what is happening? He's 20 years old and out crushing, but basic things like nutrition are like not at the forefront. You realize Pablo doesn't have any food, and so you're like, okay, I need to start packing this kid lunch. Pablo's style is like waiting for this moment of MFC, as he would call it, mental float clarity. This moment where it's super easy. And I think the sickest thing for him on the route is like how to try hard. And I know that sounds crazy because he's climbed V16.
His hardest route that he's tried is 13 plus, and now he's pretty much sending Empath. It's really rad to get inspired by kind of the next gen and see where they can take things.
And then I cam, just like that.
Whoa!
And then I'm also hand jamming too. So it's a 2-in-1.
Twofer.
Dang.
Twofer, for sure.
I need to try that.
Oh, I'm so excited to try. I want to just
teleport up there right now. You have to scale up there.
Keenan films every try and then watches it 20 times. When you're analyzing something that much, it starts to take up so much of your mind.
Whoa, right?
I put a lot of pressure on myself and I don't necessarily like that pressure.
Oh, it is really hard for me not to be mad at myself.
To see someone who you think is ready to send and they don't think they're ready, and you're just like, ah!
She'll have like some logical explanation as to why I didn't high point today.
Damn, good question. Paige with the logic.
You're absolutely right.
When you watch your friends put their heart into something, like, you want to see them succeed, and you also want to see them believe in themselves.
There's this right-hand tiny crimp on a sloper, and it basically broke the entire crimp off.
Fuck,
Hunter. I fell there for 7 days to just get totally shut down for that many days. Made me really doubt whether or not I can do the route.
Fuck! It's like when you're progressing, it's fun. You're just stuck.
For myself and for Pablo as boulderers, where we're not used to feeling much less than 90. Yeah, when you're 100, the sections are chill. Individually, whereas when you're at 70 or 60 or 50, it's stressful, and to climb well when you're like really quite tired is very difficult.
Yeah, no, I was full zone. It was amazing feeling. I was so present. I was just like, I'm here on the wall. Wind is rising. Got the zombies on support mode.
He was like, oh, I'm in it now, I can do this. And I was like, yes, you could do it all along, but I'm glad you see it now.
Like, I feel like at some point when we're kids, there's certain things where we lose confidence in ourselves for whatever reason. And so it has to be retrained that we are capable in these facets, whatever it is. I want to be a stronger climber or have more endurance, especially, so I'd be like, I have the most endurance in the world. I never get pumped. If you're on the wall and you're doing them, there's no space for negativity, which is sick.
Nothing's quite
I'll probably forget it one day, but it's, I think next year I'll still remember like the whole sequence, foot sequence included. Like,
I mean, I entered this trip knowing no lingo. Now,
but like Seahawk is like, that's, I wouldn't expect it. That is,
that's
like,
not, like,
that's like micro lingo.
I feel like you made that up.